crying like that.
Yeah, so I started going by he, him pronouns because it's just what I'm most comfortable. Who's that?
I've been summoned.
That's the gender bandit. He's going to steal our genders. But I don't want to lose my gender. Hey, we aren't looking for any trouble.
Don't worry, there is no trouble here.
Tyler, are you okay?
Actually,
call me Sapphire.
And yeah, but I think I like to go by they, them pronouns now.
Of course.
My work's done.
Everyone is always like, my pronouns are this and my pronouns are that, but I just want to be pronounced dead.
I have to go to work.
I was in the 212 on the uptown, and nigga, you know what's up, or don't you? Murder who made ya? I'm a rude bitch, nigga. What are you made up of? I'm eat your food up, boo. I could bust your eight. I'm a dealer.
You're gonna freaking flip, like seriously freaking flip, cause Sally's mad at Iggy because Iggy's booty's more biggy and Sally's booty's twiggy, so she called her friend Sibby. Now Sally's gonna get implegies.
What's implegies?
Implants, silly.
Yeah.
Assumptions I'd make about you based on your favorite punk band.
You're a business major, but none of your friends are.
You really like punk theoretically, like as a concept or whatever, but you're not all that too impressed with how most of the music actually sounds, so you're really just listening to something to avoid poser accusations.
You are the one making poser accusations. You wake up in the morning and the first thing you want to do is initiate some poser discourse. Poser is your favorite word. Beyond that though, you're cool.
You're black.
I wouldn't even know if this was your favorite punk band because you don't talk to nobody about anything.
If you're an adult and you can still take the Sex Pistols seriously, you're probably eligible for a senior citizen discount when you go shopping.
Okay, heard you, music historian.
We probably have similar tastes, and that's terrifying to me because you're annoying.
You're who Bikini Kill fans think they are. First of all, you bite. Second of all, you stink. You have to go and bathe. And this is not no little funkiness. This is not regular must, okay? This is something serious. You smell like a wicked can of bounce that ass.
I might make a part two of this if I get bored again.
Hey guy, queen man bussy. Your outfit is bootsing enema core. It's giving fun gay slur. Don't forget to wig for the holla sleigh.
I met a girl and I really thought she liked me. I truly thought that I had met the one. It was a fail, to no avail. I'm just another victim of the bad girls club. Get going, don't you wanna be-
I'm getting ready for the day, and I'm doing absolutely nothing besides working on some art stuff. But I want to be cute. So option number one is that I'm just like a neutral look, you know, and I plan a fit around my Beetlejuice book for the recently deceased belly ring. And the second option is that I'm like pink emo princess Y2K moment for that belly button ring. I don't know. I also could wear my Karomi set and do some makeup to match that, but I'm unsure. I definitely want to wear this skirt. I got shorts on. Now I want to wear it. I added socks and garters, and I've come to the unfortunate realization that this would be so much cuter with this skirt and like a white thing underneath this. I don't really want to wear that today. It low-key covers like my belly button being the star of the show, and we can't have that, so this fit does not win today. I put in the book for the recently deceased. We're no longer going for pink. I put on my doll leg tights, and I'm going to cut this up to my liking. I never wore it as a dress, so there was really no reason for it to be a dress. I'm thinking just this glove, but this glove is an option that, like, we could do. I'm honking and bonking today. Anyways, I'm gonna pick a jewelry out. It is finished. I put on a waist chain. I don't know if it looks better with or like without it. That's an opinion I'll want. Have my jewelry. I'm done. And I'm gonna go live and do my makeup.
I want to. Also, I can do this.
When you're a kid, you convince yourself that maybe the grand gesture could be enough. That even though your parents aren't what you need them to be over and over and over again, at any moment they might surprise you with something wonderful. And I kept waiting for that, the proof that even though my mother was a hard woman, deep down, she loved me and cared about me and wanted me to know that I made her life a little bit brighter.
Hi, my name is Lola Bunny.
Lola?
Yes?
Hello, my name is Bugs. You want to play a little one-on-one, doll?
Doll?
Uh-huh.
On the court.
Hello, I am Miz, and this is a list of things that I would not have gotten to experience had I... myself at 14. I am 20 now. Cutting my hair short and getting to feel like an actual person for the first time in my entire life. Figuring out that I really, really love bakery candles. Getting my first apartment with a kitchen. Getting to pick out my salt and pepper shakers and filling them with salt and also pepper. This rock. It's really cool. Hanging up my kitchen brushes. Getting to decide what color bowls will go into my cabinets. Buying a broom for the first time. This is Henry. Filling up this camera with photos of me and the absolute love of my life. Who I would not have met had I succeeded. Filling my own fridge with food that I picked out. Buying popcorn shrimp. Cork. Getting to pick out and design my own little gaming bookshelf thing. Having a spare storage closet. Getting my own bathroom that I get to decide what it looks like. We're going with a gray and a pink theme. The walls are going to be pink, and that shower curtain is gray. Our soap dispensers are also gray. Figuring out who I am and who I love. Buying my own dresser, curtain rods, and curtains.
Turns out there is, in fact, a fuck ton to live for. And it's crazy because I would have literally missed it all. But I'm glad I didn't. And you are eventually gonna be glad that you didn't too. Cause it does get better. Who would have fucking thought, right?
Today you try eating someone else for a change because the